Hey, so this is Deepak, and in this video, we'll be looking at how to deal with images while doing programmatic SEO in WordPress. So in this case, I'm using a plugin called WP All Import, which you might already know about. So I have set up a local WordPress installation, as you can see here, and it's a blank site. I don't have any posts on it yet. And this is the data I already have in a Google Sheets. So in this case, I'll be showing you two different ways you can deal with images while doing programmatic SEO in WordPress by using WP All Import. The way one will be that you have the images already hosted on an external server. For example, let's see in the case of Ladybug, we have this image. If I click on the image, this is the image that I already have. And in the second case, I only have the file name of the image, and as you can see that all the rows contain the file names of different images, and I have all the images in my local folder on my computer. So I'll be showing you both ways how you can deal with images. So let's get to it. As you can see that this is the Google Sheet that I have. I need to get started, I'll need the URL of the Google Sheet. So yeah, you need to do this setting. Anyone with the link can view. So I can copy the link, and then let's move to WordPress. So all import, then new import, download a file, and I'll just paste the Google Sheets URL here, and it fetches the data as a CSV file. So as you can see that here you have the option to choose post or pages. So in this case, we'll be going with post. Continue with next step. It says that the file has 10 rows of data, which is correct. If you see here, it has 10 rows of data. From here, let's click to the next step. And here we are. I can just quickly get started with creating the template. So in this case, I'll quickly write, learn everything about. Yeah. So I have the title here, and then I will be showing a bio here, and then I'm just writing image and then some other data. For example, let me create a list for the color, then color will be shown here, then diet, and diet will be shown here. This is just for example. Of course, your real page templates will look more complex than this. Predators, and just that. And maybe I can add name here. Yeah, just that. This is the page template. Probably the simplest one that you will ever see. So yeah, how to deal with images. Now let's see, let's move to this section. So it has three different options: download images hosted elsewhere, the second one is use images currently in the media library, which is this method that I just talked about. And the another is use images currently uploaded in the WP content uploads WP all import files folder. Okay, so we'll talk about this one at the very last. And so first let's see about download images hosted elsewhere. So in this case, the image one contains the URL of the images hosted elsewhere, right? So what the WP All Import plugin does is it downloads all the images from those external URLs to your media library, and it becomes really easy. And now what do you want to do with the images? If you just do this, then images are not going to show not going to be shown inside the post. They will just be set as the featured image, as you can see here. So if you want to show the image here, you have to write you have to go to this text editor, and then let's delete the placeholder and click on this image. So it's asking about the enter the URL of the image. So where is the URL? URL contain like this variable contains the URL. So I can just image one, then one, and then the description. So probably I'll just write name in the description. Description is like the alt text. If you click here, the image is set. Like right now, it will show broken because the images have not been downloaded yet. So yeah, just that. And so if you are using external images or dynamic images inside your post, you'll have to check this option: scan through post content and import images wrapped in image tags. So if you don't select this option, then images like downloaded will not be like these images will not be shown. They will like they will be broken. They will not work. So yeah, right now, for now, let's go with this. I can quickly set up other things, maybe categories, leave categories, everything. Maybe slugs. I have the slug, so I can just pass the slug here. Let's leave the author and move to the next step. Maybe I can just either you can auto detect or just put the slug here. Most of the time I just put the slug in this unique identifier field. And just that, I can write a friendly name as ants images. And if I run the import, what's going to happen? You can see that the import has started, and earlier there were no posts on the site. Import is complete, and if I reload this page, you will see that the images are being shown, and like 10 new posts have been generated. If I click on this post, it says learn everything about monarch butterflies. And okay, so images are showing like being shown twice because just because of the template, because template is showing the featured image at the very top. So I can just go to this template thing, the single post template, and I can like edit out the featured image. For example, this is the featured image inside the template. I can delete the featured image from the template, and if I reload, the first image will not be shown. Yeah, so right now this is the title and this is the bio that I passed in the page template, and this is the image. And if you right click on the image and open in the new tab, it says that the images have been downloaded to this local folder, like your media library. If you go to the media library, you can see that all the images have been downloaded. So this is one way to do. Earlier, there were no images in the media library. It downloaded all the images from the external links that you had to your media library and then automatically linked all the images to the posts. So this is one way to do, and this is how I do. This is how I prefer all the time. Now let's look at the second method. But for that, let me delete the generated post. So I can click here, delete posts created by ants images. Delete associated images from media library, associated files, if any. Yeah, so if you go to media library, there is nothing here. And if you go to the home page of the site and reload, then there are no posts here. So now let's go with the second method, how to deal with the images when you have all the images in your local files and then you have referenced to those files in a column. In that case, it's very similar. You just have to select one different option, others will be exactly the same. So let's go to import, edit template, and so this is the page template that we had already created. Now let's come to this images section. In this case, we are not going to download the images hosted elsewhere. Instead, we are going to like just use images which are already in the media library. And yeah, I just put the image too that contains the file names. So right now we have not uploaded all the images to the media library, but we will before running the import. So set the first image to the featured image. Okay. Yeah, it says that this image is not found in the media library. Okay, let's see. I don't know. Okay, I'll have to edit this as well because image one, instead of image one, we have to write image two. So let's see how if it works. Let me update the template, go to media library, and then upload all the images. Okay, so images have been uploaded, and now let's run the import and see what happens. Okay, it says that WP import created 10 new records. If I reload, and the featured images are being shown, if I click on here, then these are broken. But why? If I go to the media library, you can see that all the images that I uploaded are still here, but it shows broken. For that, you'll have to click on any, just click on any one of the images and then copy their URL. Copy URL to the clipboard. And then let's go to edit the template. Edit template. And see, so I am referencing this image to here, and this is not an URL, this is just the file name. It says that image source and file name and alt text, but that is not the URL from the media library. So let me paste the URL of any the one image that I like copied, and you can see that this is the complete URL, like this is the website name and WP content uploads, and this is the year and then month and then the file name. So here, if you want it to work, you will have to paste like this, put this image to that contains the file name after this. So right now when the import runs, in this case, this image two variable will be replaced by this file name, and it will be the complete image URL that will work. So I hope it works. Let me update the template and rerun it. Okay, and if I reload, you can see that the images are being shown because this time the URL of the image is correct. So these are the two different ways you can deal with images while doing programmatic SEO. And not just this, but not just one images, like one image, but you can have multiple images as well. For example, I can show one image here, I can show another image after this list, and I can have multiple images. And you just have to like press enter and put the next image variable here, and it works. So, and you have like SEO and advanced options as well. For example, if I want to set the alt text of all the images something dynamically, then you can do that as well. So I hope this is clear. And now, like, let me give you a brief overview of how this third option will work. So for that, you will have to use like client like FileZilla, which is a FTP client that connects to your server. I'm not going to show that in this video, but that connects to your server, and then you can upload all your images in this folder from your local computer to this folder on your like WordPress hosting server. And then when the import runs, it downloads all the images from this folder to your media library, and then it all works. So I hope this was clear, and if you have any questions, queries, kindly feel free to let me know in the comments, and see you in the next video. Bye.